Hello everyone and welcome back to the Software Pulse. It is Francesco D'Alessio here, your host for another news segment. So, obviously I've been away for 2 weeks now. I've been away to sunny Cyprus for a little bit of a vacation. It was a really nice relax. We got some time to enjoy the sun and put my feet up. But I also got some time to sort of recalibrate a lot of the work I'm doing too, which hopefully will reflect in the next couple of weeks' videos. So do stay tuned. And if you're new on this channel, do hit that subscription button. So just before we dive in to the news, I wanted to announce that I will be announcing two more Skillshare courses, which is great. So Things 3 will be available very soon within the month of August. Reason why I'm doing this course is mainly to overview the features and functions of Things 3. It's a very expensive application and hard to invest in sometimes when you're, you know, like a first-time buyer. Of course, they've got a free trial on Mac, but maybe you want to understand all of the platform before you invest in the iOS and Mac application. And of course, I'm doing another one on Bear, which is a note-taking or even a writer application that you can use, just the ins and outs of that. So there are two new courses coming. So I'll include links below to the current Skillshare courses, but I think you'll enjoy those. So do stay tuned in August for those. Anyway, guys, let's dive into some of the news. From some of your feedback, I've broken it into a segment, so let's start with hardware. So first off, hardware. Apple have released new Pro units. They have obviously been working on their MacBook Pro lineup. They've included new Intel processors in them and also introduced new power saving functions as well as power boosting functions, so you'll get more power for the punch as well, which is great. So that's the latest on the MacBook Pro line. Now, in other news, PC sales have actually grown for the first time in 6 years. This is quite an interesting figure. Of course, PCs are becoming a little bit easier to use as you go around the home because you've obviously got a base there and you can set up. A lot of people are going back to this desktop productivity. So it's going to be quite interesting because that's quite an important factor with these app developers. So for example, Todoist, if they see growth in desktop applications, they will invest more in their desktop apps, and that will influence the way that you experience. So just to note that, that's obviously a growth in that area and will affect apps over time. Of course, that's going to be sustained growth. Maybe that's quite interesting to you. Now, moving on to personal productivity, we all know recently this week Todoist have almost pretty much announced dark mode. Now, dark mode, which Amir tweeted on social media, is going to be a full black mode of Todoist, and it looks great, and I think it's going to be very appealing to a lot of users who like this, you know, sort of dark-skinned experience. It is absolutely fantastic. They are going to be releasing it very soon. They have said pretty much within the month on Instagram, but obviously that's provisional. Now, to follow suit, Notion have actually added a dark mode as well. Were they planning to add a dark mode? They haven't officially released it. It's in their upcoming section, which I can imagine will be available in 2.3, which I'll talk about more in the Teams tools. Now, Habitify, which is an iOS application, have added a Mac OS version. The Mac OS version is priced at $19.99, I believe it is, which is quite a steep price, but the application touts a real sort of desktop way to manage your habits and sort of experiences. So let's stay tuned for that because I will be reviewing it here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It's been a popular like sort of resource for everyone, especially on iOS. Now, in other news, Newton, disclaimer, I do work with Newton, but Newton have released Recap. Recap is a way for you to get your emails that you've had conversations in the past with. So for example, let's say you've discussed a certain date that you've got coming up. Well, Recap will basically use machine learning to pick up different emails and resurface them at relevant times so that you have all of the most important emails sort of at your fingertips. So at Newton, we've just launched that, but as you can imagine, it is getting a lot of popularity. So that's a Recap that has just been rolled out in Newton, the email app. So Drafts have added a 5.3 update with the addition of a Todoist integration, which is great news. So that has also rolled out while I've been away. So congrats to Drafts on adding that Todoist integration. Now, moving on to team productivity tools. Of course, there's been a few changes in this area. Notion has launched 2.2, which has added a few additions, the likes of inline sort of modifications with comments and also permissions. So you can be very specific about the pages and access you give to other people. So that's a really big leap for their team productivity application. Microsoft Teams have also introduced Teams for free, so you're allowed to access it in an attempt to challenge the likes of Slack. So they're offering a sort of new freemium pricing, which I'll include in the link in the description. It's been getting a lot of attention. A lot of people are enjoying the fact that this is a sort of a bit of a challenge for everyone, sort of taking down Slack. Obviously, Microsoft Teams got a long way to go, but it's something that they've taken a leap in. Now, in other news, Microsoft are releasing, well, they have released Whiteboard, an application which will allow you to visually communicate ideas, essentially in the same way you would use a whiteboard on certain applications. So that's quite an interesting update. And I believe they'll be releasing it on certain platforms, Windows being the first one. Now, in other Team Tools news, MeisterTask has now introduced their business class section, which is great. So obviously, the MeisterTask is a very popular task manager, and it's been growing in popularity. They also own, they're the company that own MindMeister, which is a popular mind mapping technology. So of course, that's going to be a good addition to their experience. So business is available, and I'll probably do a review very soon about it. So some of the offline news, GTD, a book by David Allen, GTD for kids is now available. So, well, actually, I think it's GTD for teens. I think this is something I spoke with David Allen about a year ago. I was honored to get to chat with him. And I was mentioning, you know, on the side note, have you ever considered this for like young people? And he was saying, yeah, they're working on a book at the moment. And I think it's a great addition. I haven't yet read it, only because it's just been released, and I probably will get around to reading it. But GTD for teens sort of overviews how you can manage all aspects of your productivity at a young age. And also, I think it touches on the sort of anxiety side of stuff too. So managing, you know, your emotions as well. So this is a really nice addition and something I think universities and schools should definitely consider looking into. Now, there was also some news of a Todoist redesign. Sadly, this was not a redesign. It was a concept piece of art that was rolling around the Keep Productive Facebook group. So just calm down. Alex did announce actually on his social media that they will be obviously rolling out the icons as well. So the icons will look slightly different. And I did hear on social media as well that they are working on an iOS beta. So that apparently looks quite exciting. Anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this week's news. Obviously, we'll be back and ready with some more news segments probably next week or the week after, looking at a 2-week sort of stint for this one. But I think it will be a nice roundup to the Software Pulse. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.